Democratic presidential candidate Marianne Williamson got viewers' attention Tuesday with some of the more memorable moments of the debate, and now some of her past positions on issues like antidepressants are being scrutinized.
She says, let me state it again, I'm pro-medicine, I'm pro-science, I've never told anyone not to take medicine, I've never fat-shamed anyone, and today there's a new one, no, I don't support Scientology. The machinery of mischaracterization is in high gear now, gee, did I upset someone?
So last night, Anderson Cooper had a heated discussion with Williamson, trying to learn where she stands.
You've often brought up very legitimate concerns about doctors overprescribing antidepressants and other drugs. You've brought up concerns about, which are legitimate, about aggressive marketing by big pharmaceutical companies and possible harmful side effects of antidepressant drugs. To me, those all seem very legitimate concerns to raise. I've never heard you express, though, real concern for the stigma surrounding depression. And I know there are some people who say that you're actually contributing to that stigma by repeatedly saying that antidepressant drugs, you've used the word numb or mask you. That isn't the fact is that depression numbs you and masks you, and that while some drugs have dangerous or unpleasant side effects, not all drugs numb you or mask you. And telling a seriously depressed person they take an antidepressant, they're going to be numbed, isn't that not a good message?
I think that would be a not good message, and I've never given that message. That's just never the way I've spoken, and it's a complete mischaracterization of my commentary. What I have talked about is a normal spectrum of human despair, normal human despair, which traditionally was seen as the purview of spirituality and religion, that which gave people comfort and gave people hope and inspiration in their times of pain. And with the advent of modern psychotherapy, a lot of the baton sort of passed from religion and spirituality to modern psychotherapy, which was an interesting transition. And then over the last few years, very, very quickly, the baton was passed again to psychopharmacology. And so a nuanced conversation was lost regarding the nature of human despair. Regarding the real phenomenon of human despair, this is what I have spoken about.
Right, but you have used the word numb many times and
yes.
Mask. You said, in fact, feds say 1 in 10 Americans on antidepressants, not a good sign. This is not a time in American history for any of us to be numbing our pain. If you're on an antidepressant, you're not numbing your pain. You're actually trying to feel again, no?
Well, some people would argue that, some people not. But the issue here for me is the difference between normal human despair and if you are going through something like grief, for instance.
Right, that's normal. Like, that's normal. There's you write very eloquently about
that
normal
and
universal
about,
sadness.
Right.
But do you acknowledge, you have raised questions, though, about clinical depression in the past. I know in our podcast with Russell Brand, I think you called clinical depression such a scam. And then you backtracked with the New York Times saying you regretted saying that, but you went on to say, and I'm quoting, it's not always such a scam at all. It does seem like, again, you're suggesting that clinical depression is a scam.
No. Do you want to let me tell you what I think? Because I'll be glad to do that. What I believe is that when we go through these issues of normal human despair, when we go through a divorce, when we have a pain over a breakup, when someone that we love has died, when we have been through a financial loss or failure, there is value sometimes in feeling the sadness, feeling that dark night of the soul.
When Kate Spade died, you tweeted out, how many public personalities have to hang themselves before the FDA does... how many public personalities on antidepressants have to hang themselves before the FDA does something? Big pharma cops to what it knows, and the average person stops falling for this. The tragedies keep compounding. The awakening should begin. You do seem to be implying, A, that Kate Spade was on antidepressants, which I don't think we have any knowledge of, nor is it anybody's business. But you seem to be linking, again, famous people with antidepressants and suicide, and many people who are on antidepressants have had suicidal ideation long before they were taking antidepressants.
And the FDA, there is a black box warning on antidepressants that for people 25 years old and younger, the risk of suicidal ideation is increased rather than decreased. Do you know how many teenagers and young
people... Not for people over 24. And again, just... putting out a blanket tweet when in the wake, on the day somebody has died, implying that they were on antidepressants and that's what caused their suicide, that just seems irresponsible.
Well, Anderson, I could say the same thing to you, given how many pharmaceutical companies advertise on your show.
I don't know. You know. I've never seen the ads on my show, so I don't know what pharmaceutical companies.
Well, you might want to look at it.
But I got to be telling
you. You might want to look at it.
I'm not impacted.
So when you say to
I'm
me,
not impacted by who advertises on my show. I don't know who advertises on my show. It's not any interest to me. I'm sure it is to people in this company, but I don't care. What I care about is people who are dying, and there's a stigma for people actually seeking medical help for something that could save their life. And, you know, that has saved my life. And I think it's important that, you know, when I read people saying, well, all these drugs cause suicide, I mean, that's just not true.
I don't say that. Anderson,
You have not.
On this program, I'm sorry. You said to me a few minutes ago, with all due respect, I felt very little respect here. I felt very little opportunity to say what I believe. And I feel the person who's had some blank statements said about them on this program is me. I have simply never had the blanket conversation that you are now suggesting that I've had. And when it comes to people who are suicidal, I have a 35-year career working with people in despair. I have had a 35-year career working with people in crisis. I've had a 35-year career working with people in pain. I have people who psychiatrists send to me to have worked with them. I have been up close and personal with people in their pain and right. in their despair for decades.
I never said you're glib.
Is a complete mischaracterization right. and misrepresentation of my career.
Right. And I'm not casting aspersions on your career or saying you're glib in any way. You are deadly serious about this, and you have very strong beliefs, and I'm discussing them with you.
I just don't understand
some of your public statements, and you've addressed them.
Anderson, then let me speak. This is not a conversation that we're having.
Well, I think it is. I need to try to... You say you didn't say stuff, and then I read you quotes, and this is a conversation.
Explain. When people are taking antidepressants who have had serious pain and serious depression in their lives, and they are helped by them, I'm happy for them.
Yeah. Yes, I
am happy for them. When I meet young people, and I meet them all the time, once again, I'm the one here who has had a lot of experience with people in pain.
I think you have expressed your opinion tonight. Some of the language you've used, it has raised concerns, and I think it's fair that I ask those questions, and I think you've addressed them very well.